Good morning to all. Today we are going to start with our final chapter of this book, Globalization. In the beginning, we will try to understand the meaning of globalization and its causes and political, economic and cultural consequences of globalization and how India has been affected by globalization. And in the end, we will also try to discuss the positive and negative effects of globalization. So let us start the thing. In the beginning, there are three stories mentioned in the book. First of all, I must tell you that what is globalization? It is the flow of idea, capital, commodity, and movement. And people's movement, the movement of idea, capital, commodity and people from one part of the country to another part of the country and from one country to another country. In the beginning, one example has been given. Janardan, he works in a call center. He leaves for the office in the evening. At that time, he works all night, which is actually the daytime for his overseas customers. He is working in a customer care center, call center you can call, and he is giving his services to somebody to whom he'll never meet physically. This is his daily routine, and his holidays also do not match with the Indian calendar because his holidays match with the calendar of United States. The second story here has been given about Ramdhari. He has gone to buy a birthday gift for his 9-year-old daughter because he has promised that he will buy a small cycle for her. So that's why he decides to search in the market. The thing which is quite affordable and at reasonable quality should also be reasonable. And finally, he buys a bicycle which was actually manufactured in China, but it is being marketed in India. And he also remembered one thing, that in her last birthday he had bought her a Barbie doll which was originally manufactured in US but was being sold in India. The third story is about Sarika. She is first generation learner and remarkably she is doing very well throughout her school and college life. She works very hard in studies and now she has got an opportunity to take on a job and begin an independent career. But the woman section of her family was opposing. Her relatives were opposing. She finally decides to go ahead because of the new opportunities that have been made available to her generation. All the three examples, they tell us about the aspect of what we call globalization. Janardan, he is participating in the globalization of services. He is rendering his services to his overseas clients. Ramdhari, he is trying to purchase a bicycle and he has purchased one bicycle and one doll, Barbie doll for his daughter. That tell us something about the movement of commodities from one part of the world to another. From China, the bicycle has moved to India through market. And at the end, the third story in Sarika's case, she is facing one conflict of ideas and values that was partly originating from a new opportunity that earlier was not available to the woman in her family, but today is part of reality that has gained wider acceptability. Today, everything has been accepted. The woman section is doing wonderfully well in all fields of society. Now let us see that if we look certain examples of globalization in our real life, these are all the movement of ideas and services and commodities that are moving from one part of the country, one country to another country. But it has, we should look also some of the negative impacts of globalization. That in first example, some farmers, they have committed suicide because their crops have failed. They had bought expensive seeds from multinational company and now they have to pay money back, but the crops have failed. That's why many farmers have committed suicide. In the second example, that is also a negative impact of globalization. An Indian company bought a major rival company based in Europe despite protests by some of the current owners. Owners are protesting, but till now the Indian company has bought a rival company which is situated in Europe. Many retail shopkeepers, they fear that they would lose their livelihoods if some major international companies open retail chains in the country. If MNCs, international companies, if they'll open their companies in India, then retail shopkeepers, they will lose their livelihood. That is also a negative impact. A film producer in Mumbai, he was accused of lifting the story of his film from another film that was made in Hollywood. हॉलीवुड की स्टोरी से स्टोरी को चुराकर मुंबई के प्रोड्यूसर ने अपनी एक फिल्म प्रोड्यूस की है एंड ही इज अक्यूज्ड ऑफ दैट. मिलिटेंट ग्रुप्स दे हैव इशूड वन स्टेटमेंट दैट इफ द गर्ल्स विल स्टार्ट वेयरिंग जीन्स व्हाइल गोइंग टू स्कूल्स और कॉलेजेस देन दे विल बी शॉट डाउन. So these were the negative consequences for the people. Indeed, there are many who believe that globalization has more negative consequences than positive. Now these were certain examples. But before that, let us try to know the meaning of globalization, the definition of globalization, that what is the concept of globalization. Here it comes. Globalization as a concept fundamentally deals with flows. It is flow or movement. That these flow could be of various kind. First kind can be ideas moving from one part of the world to another. Second, it is the movement of capital shunted between two or more places. Capital means money, commodities or services being traded across borders. Services like, just like Janardhan, he is providing his services to the overseas clients, and movement of people in search of better livelihood, that we call brain drain. People from India, they are moving to Australia, Canada, New Zealand in search of better livelihoods to different parts of the world. This is the movement of people and we call it globalization. Worldwide interconnectedness that has been created and it has sustained as a consequence of these constant flows, because once interconnectedness has been created through worldwide, the consequences can be seen in negative form. So this is all with today's topic. I hope the concept of globalization is clear. Thank you. Have a nice day. Stay at your houses and stay safe.